It's the world's first weaponized robot, and it can be armed with everything from a machine gun to a rocket launcher.
We've shot rockets off of this system before. We've shot 40-millimeter grenades off the system already. Anything that can be shot by a human can be shot by the sword.
It's no wonder Time magazine voted this sinister-looking little robot one of the greatest inventions of the 21st century. That's why I'm headed to the Army Research and Development Center to see how bad this little monster is in person. And lucky for me, I've been given exclusive access to the next set of live demonstrations. This smart, wheeled assassin is controlled by a soldier, calling the shots at a safe distance from the enemy.
The swords robot will be used to extend the standoff between a soldier and the enemy. A soldier can drive his weapon remotely up to 800 to 1,000 meters away and be able to fire his weapon from the safe distance of obscurity.
Bob Quinn is the general manager of Talon Robots at Foster Miller, the designers of swords. It's the first armed robot that will actually see action, giving the soldier a powerful ally on today's front line. The swords will carry out many of the same duties as a regular soldier: checkpoint security, guarding observation posts, or even acting as a lone sniper. Now, instead of sending in soldiers to clear out buildings filled with insurgents, the job can be done by a robot. And that, of course, can dramatically reduce fatalities on the front line. The technology evolved from the Talon, a vehicle designed for search and rescue missions and bomb disposal units.
These robots are being used in the battlefield every day for explosive ordnance disposal missions. The mission count is over 80,000 missions where small robots have been used to defeat improvised explosive devices on the sides of roads and inside buildings.
The team first created a lightweight platform that could work in all kinds of conditions. It could travel through snow, sand, climb stairs, and even go underwater, down to the depths of 100 feet to find its target. The smart device could reach inside enemy buildings, enter dark alleyways, or head down streets filled with insurgents. Then they decided to weaponize it.
The inspiration behind the idea came from a sergeant here at Picatinny Arsenal at the Explosive Ordnance Disposal Group, Sergeant David Platt. And David Platt was with Talons at World Trade Center doing search and rescue missions. He came back with the idea of not just using an arm and a claw and a hand that would reach out and pick up an unexploded ordnance device, but actually put a weapon system, including a machine gun, onto the robot.
Now they've created a deadly combat weapon. And its presence alone packs an incredible psychological punch.
Even without having to fire it or do anything, just having somebody walk around the corner and come upon it facing a weapon, and they have no idea what it is, it's total shock and awe.
Staff Sergeant Scott Smith is one of the engineers at the helm of the Swords project.
It's definitely good that way. It's very usable.
They've added a bank of video surveillance cameras to give the operating soldier a unique view of the battlefield.
Right now we have